With its more than 150-year-old history, Indian Railways is a state-owned public utility of the Government of India under the Ministry of Railways. As a national common carrier, transporting passengers and goods over its vast network, Indian Railways has always played a key role in India's social and economic development. Northern Zone is the shining star of the railways of India. It has easily achieved its objective to cover vast distances and create a benchmark of success for the other zones to follow. This zone spreads extensively across Delhi, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Punjab, Union Territory of Chandigarh, Himachal Pradesh, Jammu and Kashmir, and Uttarakhand. The Jammu and Kashmir state, situated in the extreme north of India, has limited surface accessibility from the rest of the country. Till recent times, bringing rail to Kashmir Valley was a dream. Before 1947, the Jammu and Kashmir state was connected to the rest of India by rail via Jammu-Sialkot route. With the partition, however, the state disappeared from the railway map for about 25 years, till the link was re-established via Jammu-Pathankot route in late 1972. Negligible traces of the Jammu-Sialkot track at Gulabgarh, a border village near Suchitgarh in Ranbir Singhpura, with an abandoned old structure of the then important railway station at RSpora, a track change lever, besides an old structure of a bridge, is what one can find as the remains of this historic route now. Though the possibility of joining the beautiful and picturesque valley of Kashmir with the remaining Indian railway network was explored towards the end of the 19th century, it remained a dream till the project was announced in 1982. Conceptualized in 1886, the project failed to come up for over a century. It was in April 1886 that Maharaja Pratap Singh met Lord Dufferin and suggested a railway track to Kashmir. However, after a detailed survey submitted in January 1890, it was returned back saying that the Jammu-Akhnoor-Banihal track of 175 miles would cost 3,07,16,350 rupees. Later, after several surveys on different tracks, the British government referred to the claim made by another British engineer, Wild Blood, that laying a track from Jammu to Srinagar via Riyasi was possible. Since it bypassed the snowed areas, it was said to be even better. There were two more efforts made in 1928 and 1937, following which the project fell off the priorities. In the post-partition era, a special reconnaissance survey was undertaken in July 1962. And later, on the instance of Defence Ministry in 1964, followed by two others in 1971 and 1972. However, the work on the survey carried out in 1982 by the final location engineer survey was completed in 1983. In fact, the Government of India planned to provide a reliable transport system in this mountainous region, crossing major earthquake zones, making it the most difficult railway project taken up in India. Officially termed as Jammu-Udhampur-Srinagar-Baramula Rail Link, JUSBRL, this project was declared as a national project by the Vajpayee government in 2002, which meant that it would be completed irrespective of the cost. and the funding would be done by the Union Government under PMO's supervision. A deadline of August 2007 was also set, which seemed almost impossible. The daring task of constructing tunnels through this difficult terrain has been a big challenge for the Indian Railways. In fact, the entire terrain falls in seismic zones 4 and 5, which are considered geographically the most prone areas to earthquakes. The entire area has seen the worst earthquakes of human history and is subjected to extreme temperatures of cold and heat. For the construction of the passage between Kashmir Valley and the outside region, many tunnels and bridges needed to be constructed to surpass this difficult terrain and deep gorges. With connecting of Banihal, the last town of Jammu province, with Kashmir Valley in June 2013 and Katara with Udhampur in July 2014, the goal of connecting the paradise on earth to the rest of the country is in sight now, and by 2018 this dream may come true.
It has been a long cherished dream of this subcontinent that the Vale of Kashmir is joined with the rest of India, and the thought process started way back during the British era when a few surveys were done along Chenab, along Jhelum, but a concrete step was taken in the year 1994 when this project was sanctioned that there will be a railway line from Jammu up to Srinagar and beyond.
Running from Jammu to Baramulla, a historic town in Kashmir, this line is about 327 kilometers in length, and it will be joining the valley with the remaining Indian railway network. The railway board is responsible for technical guidance and coordination of overall progress of this project. The work on this project is progressing at a satisfactory pace. In order to expedite its completion and considering the magnitude of the task at hand, this project was split into four legs, which are Leg 0, Jammu-Udhampur, Leg 1, Udhampur-Katra, Leg 2, Katra-Kazigund, and Leg 3, Kazigund-Baramulla. Leg 0. The first portion of the JUSBRL project extending from Jammu to Udhampur was completed and dedicated to the nation on the 4th of April 2005. Though the foundation stone for the project was laid by the then Prime Minister, late Srimati Indira Gandhi, at the entry point of the Udhampur railway station on 14th April 1983. This 53-kilometer-long railway line was constructed and completed by Northern Railways at a cost of 520 crore rupees. Using the latest technology, the railway line has been laid with 20 tunnels, about 10 kilometers in length, with 34 major and 124 minor bridges. This track is bustling with numerous trains and passengers. The railway line passing through hill stations like Bajalta, Sangar, Manwal and Ramnagar also touches the hearts of the locals of all age groups, who express their joy by merely watching it and boosting their business activities and saving their time and money. Laying of a railway line on rocks and cliffs in this section was not an easy task. Due to the topography of the Shivalik ranges, but the engineers, labourers and the railway officials made it possible with their determination. The stylish Tavi Bridge on River Tavi near Manwal, with 245 meters in length, joins another bridge, E18, with 1187 meters in length, to cover both riverbed and the land. This bridge is a wonderful example of engineering in this section. The Sardhan and Gambhir bridges on this route are other examples of the engineering feat. The Sardhan bridge, again with slight curves, is surrounded by small valleys and hillocks with a variety of scenic beauty. The length of this bridge is 620 meters. The Gambhir Bridge is 77 meters high and is the highest rail bridge in this section. At a sleepy village named Dwadhar, besides a small bridge, both the railway and road transport tunnels are seen coming closer to each other. The Northern Railways has devised its own technique for better ride quality with reinforced concrete piers for all viaducts, long welded tracks laid on heavier rails, and ballast-less tracks in tunnels with proper ventilation. A land of grand ancient temples and beautiful palaces, the starting point of the JUSBRL project, Jammu, is a city where the past still has a living presence. Raghunath Temple is a well-known holy shrine of the Hindus situated in Jammu city. This famous temple is dedicated to Lord Ram. Again, the Bahu Fort is another place of religious and cultural importance. Leg 1. This section of the line extends 25 kilometers from Udhampur to Katra and is constructed by Northern Railway Construction Organization. Though the major work on tunneling and bridges in this section was completed in 2007 only, but due to certain technical problems like soil conditions in tunnel T23, there was a delay in completion of this section. In order to rectify these problems, international consultants were hired. And finally, this significant section of the project was completed in 2013. Udhampur, at a height of 861 meters above the... After passing through T23, the train runs over a major bridge, number 186 of this section, which is constructed across the Jhajjar Khad Gorge near Tikri village. This bridge is the longest steel girder bridge in India, with a maximum height of 85 meters. The longest span of this bridge is 154 meters. Another major bridge in this section is Dwadhar Bridge, which is an exemplary work of engineering. The approximate cost of this stretch amounted to 1150 crore rupees. The line was opened for the public, especially the devotees of Mata Vaishno Devi, by the Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi when he inaugurated the first train, the Sri Shakti Express, at Katra Railway Station on the 4th of July 2014. This day was of a great significance for the local populace of Katra and other adjacent areas of Riyasi and Udhampur districts.
Katra mein hamara business hai, uske baad jab Srinagar se koi samaan wagera dry fruit wagera aata hai to hamara Srinagar mein train pahunch jayegi to wahan se direct samaan aane ke liye dikkat nahi hogi kyunki Srinagar mein jaane ke liye gaadiyon ka ek ek din pura lagta tha, jam lag jata tha.
The Katra railway station in itself is a mixture of aesthetics, faith and engineering, which greets millions of devotees of Mata Vaishno Devi before their holy journey to the cave.
I कटरा में रहती हूँ। यहाँ पे ट्रेन पहले ट्रेन नहीं आती थी, मगर जब से ट्रेन यहाँ पे आई है यात्रियों को यहाँ पे बहुत ही अच्छी सुख सुविधाएं हो गई हैं। लोग सीधे जहाँ पे भी उन्होंने जाना हो जल्दी पहुँच जाते हैं और उनका टाइम भी वेस्ट नहीं होता है, इसलिए यहाँ पे ट्रेन के आने की वजह से बहुत अच्छा हुआ।
After Katra having been linked with Udhampur by train, this rail link has made the pilgrimage easier for those devotees who could not make it due to the arduous bus journey from Jammu to Katra in the past.
7-8 bar main Vaishno Devi aa chuka hu. Pehle Jammu tak aata tha, Jammu se bus se Katra tak aata tha. Katra aane tak bahut pareshani hoti thi. Abhi suvidha hone se इतना इजी हो गया कि तकलीफ कम हो गई है।
लेग 2, द कटरा खाजीगुंड सेक्शन ऑफ USBRL प्रोजेक्ट विल बी 128 किलोमीटर्स लॉन्ग एंड इज द टफेस्ट प्रोजेक्ट अंडरटेकन बाय द इंडियन रेलवेज विद 33 ब्रिजेस, 10 स्टेशंस एंड अ टनल लिंक ऑफ 100 किलोमीटर्स इन लेंथ। द स्पेशल फीचर ऑफ दिस सेक्शन is that 80% of the track will be covered by tunnels and 12% by bridges, thus leaving only 8% open.
The Himalayan mountains are the youngest mountain series in the world and have the most complex and difficult geology, which is more complex and difficult even than the Alpine and the Andes mountains. And therefore, construction of an infrastructure project in this area has its own unique challenges.
The Katra Dharam section of this leg has been given to Konkan Railways Corporation Limited, while the Dharam Khazigund Baramula section was given to Irkon International Limited. Konkan Railways Corporation Limited, a major player in this section, is a subsidiary of the Indian Railways. The company started its full operations of trains on 26 January 1998. Konkan Railway Corporation Limited is at the forefront of research and development of new technologies and concepts for Indian Railways. The stretch between River Chenab and Banihal falls through uncharted territory and required the construction of about 190 kilometers of access roads to reach the construction sites. However, out of the 190 kilometers, 175 kilometers of access roads have already been constructed. Still, some heavy machinery was airlifted to the construction sites.
The Udhampur-Srinagar-Baramulla rail link project is one of the toughest projects in the country. From Katra towards Dharam, initially one has Sirban Dolomite formation, which are as old as 2500 million years. This Sirban Dolomite is characterized by mild to very densely jointed. Due to these joints, these rock which are very hard as unit mass strength are very poor as a rock mass. So tunneling becomes very difficult. I'm very happy to say that with the diligent efforts of the project authorities, the engineers, the big challenges of tunneling have been overcome.
Irkon International Limited, a public sector railway construction company, is in charge of 175 kilometers long Dharam Khazigund Baramulla section of the project, which is another tough but less brutal section of the line. Out of the 175 kilometers line, 136 kilometers stretch, including railway line in Kashmir Valley and line through Pir Panjal Tunnel, has already been made operational. The Katra Banihal section of the Udhampur Srinagar Baramulla rail line, which is under construction, will traverse to Riyasi after Katra. This stretch will have stations at Riyasi, Salal A, Salal B, Dugga, Basindadhar, Sangaldan, Dharam, Sumbar, Arpinchal, and Banihal. Riyasi is one of the oldest towns of the state. It was the seat of the erstwhile Bhimgarh state, said to have been established by Raja Bhimdev somewhere in the 8th century and is situated on the banks of the river Chenab. This historic town is located at a distance of 64 kilometers from Jammu. A historical fort named as Riyasi Fort is located in this town on a hillock. Tunnels T1, T2, T3 and T5 fall in Riyasi area. And a special bridge on Anjikhad River is under construction, which will be joining T2 and T3. Riyasi railway station will fall between T3 and T5, which is under construction.
This tunnel T5 connects Grand Mode of Riyasi or the Riyasi station later on to the village Bakkal on the other side, and following Bakkal we have another station, Salal A, and following Salal A we have the Chenab Bridge on which the Salal B station is also located.
Again, the Katra Banihal segment of the line will have a mega bridge over the river Chenab near Salal in Riyasi district. The height of this bridge from the riverbed will be 359 meters, which will make it the tallest rail bridge in the world and will overtake the Millau Viaduct Bridge in southern France with 323 meters height. The main arch of this bridge will have a span of 467 meters, which gives it another distinction, being the longest single-span railway arch bridge in the world. Again, the length of this bridge will be 1.315 kilometers. A very elaborate procedure has been followed, as there is no Indian code for designing mega structures. CBPU, Chenab Bridge Project Undertaking, a joint venture of Messrs. EFCONS, Ultra Engineering and VSL India, has been awarded the contract for design and construction of the Chenab Bridge for 512 crore rupees. Next to the Chenab Bridge on Katra Banihal section of the line falls Tunnel 6, the construction work of which is almost complete. Other tunnels which are near completion after T6 are T9, T10, T11 and T12. The next station at Dugga will fall between Tunnel 12 and Tunnel 13. The significance of this station will be that two bridges numbered Bridge 58 and 59 will form a part of this station. The work on the next section from Dugga to Sangaldan is likely to be taken up for construction soon, with another station on it, namely Basindada. The next important station on this line will be Sangaldan, which falls between tunnels 41 and 42.
This is the Sangaldan station yard, which is 1500 meters long and which connects tunnel T40-41 on one end and 42-43 at the other. These tunnels also incorporate wider section to accommodate the loop lines of the Sangaldan station yard, which is 56 meters in 40-41 and 70 meters in 42-43.
Tunnels 43, 44, 45, 46 and 47 will be falling between Sangaldan and Dharam. All these tunnels in respect of construction are mostly complete. In order to reach Sangaldan area conveniently from Ramban, a road transport bridge on River Chenab at Dhamkund was constructed by Konkan Railways and opened for traffic in 2013. Dharam will be the next hilly station on this track, the starting point of tunnel T48. Which will be another engineering feat on this section.
Tunnel T48 twin tube tunnel है और इसमें main tunnel है और escape tunnel है. Main tunnel में जो है railway track जाएगी. Escape tunnel जो है emergency type of tunnel है. अगर कुछ समस्या आती है तो इससे exit कर सकते हैं escape tunnel से.
Dharam will be catering to the needs of many hilly habitations of the area. With an added at Kohli, this tunnel will open at Sumbar, the next station of leg 2. Sumbar railway station will be built on an open stretch of 1 kilometer and will be connecting tunnel T48 and tunnel T49, which will be 12.75 kilometers in length and longer than the 11.215 kilometer Pir Panjal tunnel. The construction work on T48 is going on in full swing. There will be another hilly station at Arpinchal, which falls between Sumbar and Banihal stations on the line. The work on this station is going on, and this will fall between T49 and T50. From Dharam onwards, the work on this section is being carried out by Ircon International Limited and HCC. The year 2012 ended on a resounding note for Northern Railways, with the successful completion of the construction of Banihal-Kazigund section of Dharam-Kazigund-Baramula rail link. This is the most singular achievement, not only for the Indian Railways, but for the entire country. The most significant part of the USBRL project in Leg 2, the Pir Panjal Tunnel, was inaugurated by the then Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh on 26 June 2013. And thrown open for the public. Banihal, a sleepy hill town, falls on the southern portal of Pir Panjal Tunnel. This 11.216 kilometer railway tunnel, constructed across the Pir Panjal mountain range by Ircon International Limited for Northern Railways, is not only a marvel of human endeavor and engineering, but also a dream come true for the people of Jammu and Kashmir. This tunnel, which connects Kazigund, the last southern town of Kashmir Valley, with Banihal, the last northeastern town of Jammu province, has been made waterproof and is equipped with state-of-the-art air quality monitoring, communications, ventilation, firefighting and emergency rescue systems. A 3-meter wide road has also been provided inside the tunnel for maintenance and relief and rescue operations in the case of any eventuality. This 11.216 kilometer long Pir Panjal Tunnel, the longest transportation tunnel in India and the second longest in Asia, has come up after piercing through the Pir Panjal range below the snow line. The 18-kilometer-long Banihal-Kazigund section, constructed at a cost of 1,691 crore rupees, has reduced the travel distance from 35 kilometers by road to 18 kilometers by rail link. Leg 3. The Kazigund-Srinagar-Baramula section is 119 kilometers long and falls in the Kashmir Valley. The foundation stone of this section was laid by Sri I.K. Gujral, the then Prime Minister of India, near Kazigund town, the entry point of Valley Kashmir, in July 1997. Though there are no tunnels in this section, heavy bridging is done across many tributaries of the river Jhelum and the roads crossing the line. This section has 64 major and 748 minor bridges and 15 railway stations. The maximum height of a bridge is 13 meters in this section and the longest span is 45 meters. The work on this section was completed in 2008 and was commissioned in parts. The 69-kilometer Mazhama Anantanag section became functional on 11th October 2008. And thrown open for the public. The Mazhama Baramula stretch was made functional on 14th February 2009. Yet, the Kazigund Anantanag stretch was made functional and thrown open for the public on 28th October 2009. Since the Banihal Kazigund Srinagar Baramula rail line has already been constructed and trains are running on it, the Katra-Banihal rail line, once completed, will link Kashmir Valley with the rest of the country and will go a long way in integrating the people of Jammu and Kashmir, the strategically important border state, into the national mainstream. The advantages of this rail line will be far more than providing an all-weather transport facility to the people of Kashmir, which is snowbound for a significant part of the year and enclosed on all sides by mountains. Snowy peaks, frozen lakes, and chilling cold is what the world understands when we talk of the winter in Kashmir. It gives you much more enjoyment of the wonderful landscape and paddy fields, besides a unique experience of traveling on the paradise on earth. Kashmir, it has often been said for centuries, is an indefinable beauty. Noted travelers and historians felt it is nature's blessing to the universe. For a historian, it is about rediscovering the beating grounds of various races and civilizations, Hindu, Buddhist, Islamic. Kashmir has often been referred to as Switzerland of the East or Paradise on Earth, as defined by Mughal Emperor Jahangir through this couplet: Agar Firdaus bar rooh-e zameen ast, hami ast ho, hami ast ho, hami ast. If there is a paradise on earth, it is here, and it is here. Not only because of its indefinable beauty, Kashmir is also world famous because of its cottage and small industries, especially the handicrafts, carpets, the luxury furnishings, woolen and pashmina shawls, gabbas, namdas, paper mache, baskets, wood carving and copperware are the ones which fetch livelihood for thousands of Kashmiris. The first shawls which reached Europe were bought by Napoleon, who presented the same to the Empress Josephine. Architecture is another field where Kashmir has a distinction. Khatamban, the finest woodwork on ceiling under roofs of the buildings, has a worldwide fame and is a typical craftsmanship of Kashmir. Wood carving is another craft, and carving in chenar wood, again a famous giant tree of Kashmir with world fame, has its own significance. Willow trees are also found in abundance in Kashmir, which form the basic raw material for cricket bats. Undoubtedly, exposing these crafts to the masses from outside the state will get fortunes to these artisans once the USBRL project is completed.
When completed, this railway line will become the lifeline for the development of the state of J&K, as it will connect the valley with the rest of the country. And this will bring in large volumes of tourists, as well as there will be avenues for development of industries along the alignment.
While taking a ride from Khazigund to Baramulla, known as Valley of Kashmir by train, we touch or come closer to many famous places on both sides of the track, which are of great historic significance. These places may take you back in history, spanning over about three centuries. The historic and most ancient city of Baramulla stands at the tail end of the track. This town, called Varmul by Kashmiris, is as old as the Valley of Kashmir itself and was founded by Raja Bhimsena in 2306 BC. The noted Chinese traveler Huan Zhang visited this historic town in 632 AD. He stayed in a vihar near Baramulla, which happened to be a Bodh research center in the 1st century AD. The 4th World Buddhist Council was held in Kashmir in Kanishka's time. In order to promote pilgrim tourism in Kashmir, J&K Tourism Department has decided to develop a Buddhist tourist circuit of Kashmir. Baramulla can be a sought-after pilgrimage center after the rail link is connected to the rest of the country.
Baramulla, which happens to be the ancient town of Kashmir, wherein we had connection with the central Asian countries as well as the mainland of India in the ancient times. We are also having the potential of an ancient Buddhist site, which is fourth Buddhist council site when the Buddhist council happened. Third was happening in Haravan and the fourth happened in Baramulla.
The chugging of a train across the state from Baramulla to Jammu would not only give a great solace to the students of the state studying in the educational institutions outside, but to the security personnel also who would travel to their native places. Some of the main objectives of this project of national importance are reducing the travel time to various destinations in the state considerably, providing of all weather transportation system in the difficult terrain that could not function in adverse weather conditions, boosting the socio-economic development of the state.
मैं यहाँ टीके कॉलेज में पढ़ता हूँ, वहाँ पे मैं मेडिकल असिस्टेंस कर रहा हूँ, और मैं अनंतनाग से हर रोज आता था, सोमू से कभी बस से आता था, 200-300 रुपए हर रोज किराया लगता था, जब से ट्रेन की सर्विस हुई तब से हमें काफ़ी सहूलियत हुई है।
मुझे लगता है सब लोगों के लिए बहुत अच्छा है, तो जो हम पहले 4 घंटे में सफ़र तय करते थे या 5 घंटे, वो शायद 2 घंटे में 2.5 घंटे में हो जाता है।
पिछले कई सालों से ये ट्रेन चली है, जो हम मुलाजिम लोग हैं या कई और भी कारोबारी लोग हैं या बीमार लोग हैं, उनको काफ़ी फ़ायदा इससे मिला।
लैंडस्लाइड्स या स्नोफॉल की वजह से रोड बहुत दिनों तक क्लोज होता था, या जो पैसेंजर्स ऑन द वे होते थे वो भी कई कई रातों तक फंस जाते थे, तो इस वजह से ट्रेन सर्विस शुरू होने से इट्स बिकम वेरी हैसल फ्री।
एंड लास्ट बट नॉट द लीस्ट, मीटिंग द स्ट्रेटेजिक डिमांड ऑफ द कंट्री, द सोशियो इकोनॉमिक इंपैक्ट ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट विल बी फार रीचिंग फॉर द स्टेट विद रिलायबल कनेक्टिविटी टू फार फ्लंग एरियाज ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर बाय रेल। विद द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ एक्सेस रोड्स, मेनी विलेजेस विल गेट कनेक्टेड एंड वुड हेल्प इन द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ दोज एरियाज। The project would generate employment for local people as well as for others, while permanent job in railways was provided to one of the family members whose more than 75% land was acquired for the project. In other words, after its completion, the project will give a considerable boost to the development and economy of the state as well as the country. This project is not an end in itself, but the beginning of new vistas of trade beyond the borders. As a matter of fact, all modern nations have started with railways, looking forward to the high noon of development. The day may not be far when this rail line will form a route as important as the Silk Route, connecting India with the most important countries of Central Asia. Restore broken bonds. Revisit lost destinations. Travel across paradise. Journey through tranquility. Explore enchantment on the train to Kashmir. Thank you.